Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and it's time for an Isaac run here on the channel. But of course, before we get to that, if you've not seen the previous episode, there's your spoiler warning. Go watch it now, because in 3 seconds, I'm going to be spoiling it for you. Go do it, although it's probably good if you didn't, because it was terrible. So yeah, the last run was quite awful. It was about as standard as Blue Baby runs get, to be quite honest. And yeah, I'm glad to have that that run day behind us. We weren't doing too good in the Binding of Isaac that day, but it's a brand new day, it's a brand new Isaac run, and we can just, it's that run's done and over with. We don't have to care about it anymore. I've already forgotten about it. What game are we playing again? StarCraft? So, we get to go ahead and get ourselves off with a brand new Isaac run, looking forward to maybe have a repeat of the last Isaac run, which was a hard-fought one to be sure. By the way, last Isaac run, not last run, because the last run was a Blue Baby run, which I already talked about, which was a very sad face. And disappointing, which is usually hand-in-hand with sad face. The beans, really bad. Really, really, really bad. Sad Onions is really good. So with Sad Onions is a massive tiers increase, a shot speed increase, I should say. And it synergizes beautifully with pretty much any damage item in the game. I can't think of one that it doesn't synergize well with. So we will go into our curse room after the boss fight. Let's go ahead and see what is in store for us. Gonna be Famine. He's been showing up a lot lately, and I really don't like seeing Famine on the first floor. Ooh, it's Blue Famine, so that's gonna be even more annoying because he's gonna be shooting everywhere. Normally the blue version of all champions is the worst version. In certain situations, it can be okay. Like Blue Mom is, Blue Chub is okay. Blue Chub's great. He's guaranteed to give you Spirit Heart, I think. But he also moves a lot slower than normal. Okay. But yeah, seeing Famine on floor one is just kind of like a, it's kind of like a big ball of disappointment. It's like, yay, we get a cube of meat. We also need to stop taking damage, by the way. That'd be great if you could do that, Isaac. Just go ahead and stop taking damage. Appreciate it. Get a Spirit Heart. We'll pick that up on our way out the door. We do have a bomb, so it's relatively possible. Nope, never mind. Friends to the End. That's also been showing up a lot in Curse Rooms lately. Don't know why. I don't really want to sacrifice another Red Heart to get out. I think it's cheaper to just spend the bomb. Not going to go in our shop. Even if we wanted to, we can't because we don't have a key. And we're done. So we got a super duper good tiers upgrade, and that's about it. 6 cents. It's enough to spawn an arcade possibly on this floor. Would be very rare too, but it's not unheard of anyway. Curse room's here. I think we're better off just going into the boss room immediately. Hoping to get deals with the devil, maybe. We've actually had a lot of deals. Whoa! Okay. Gotta love that Isaac physics, man. It's quite interesting sometimes. So we've been having a lot of deal with the angels lately, and I don't know why. I'm not sure if it's because we've been getting really awful devil deal items, or it's because we're really lucky. Now, if you ask anyone who's a seasoned Binding of Isaac player, they're gonna tell you that they'd rather take deal with the devil rooms than deal with the angels, just because the angels primarily don't give you any damage. All they can really give you is Blood of the Martyr, Halo, and Sacred Heart. That's the only things I can think of. I don't remember if the Holy Grail actually gives a damage up. It might. I know they give you flying. That's about it. So we get HP. It's good. Should be. I'm not looking for Krampus. Mom's Knife or Brimstone. I'm gonna take the easy way out here. I'm gonna reroll Mom's Knife. Book of Blau. No thanks. Gotta have it. I gotta have my Brimstone, man. After that Blue Baby run, I can be forgiven for wanting a little relaxation. Some R&R is in order after that last run. I mean, even though it is on a different day. Joker card? Nope. Even though it was on a different day since recording it. Wow. It's gonna be good. Alright. 2 HP upgrades on this floor plus Brimstone. I could not be happier. Could probably bomb our way into the shop if we get another bomb. Maybe. Maybe possibly. Still have a curse room to go to. The shop is still a little bit out of reach for us right now. If we get more money, then maybe we'll start thinking about it. Brimstone obviously super good. my favorite item in the game by far. I think everyone knows that by now. Let's see what this is. Moon. That takes us to our secret room, which I will use right now. Because I want to get money, and I don't really have enough bombs to really guess. This is where I thought it was going to be, and what's so nice about this is that now we can get into the shop without having a key, thanks to the moon card. And we get a half-price compass. That's amazing. That is super amazing wagon adventure good. I will go into that other room here, because it's possible we may get a chance to reroll something in the curse room. Which, of course, shares the deal with the devil, deal with the angels loot pool, which is very good indeed. There you go. So, yeah, super amazing good run so far on this floor, anyway. We got two HP upgrades. We're basically starting with Isaac's base health, except we have Brimstone and a Tears upgrade, so that's really good. Pills. We don't know what these are. Range down, doesn't matter. Tears down. Also, kind of doesn't matter, but it does matter. I think Sad Onion is worth like two. It requires two or three range downgrades to cancel out the positive effects of a Sad Onion, I think. But range down doesn't matter because we have Brimstone, and we will have Brimstone for the rest of this run. However long that is, of course, is left up to the beholder. Well, I guess it's left up to me. I guess I would, in a sense, be the beholder. So there is an arcade here. I don't know why I cleared down to the item room, because it's not like we can get in. Maybe I'm just a big derp. So we're going to have to do some gambling on this floor. That's okay. We don't have a bomb. We don't have a bomb, meaning that we cannot safely get into or out of. Our movement speed's not good enough. That's alright. I knew that there was this heart here, so it's not that big of a deal, but I was hoping that maybe we can get into the shop, or into the arcade, without having to lose that spirit heart, but whatever. Chances are we're probably not going to get a deal with the devil since we just got one. It's not guaranteed, but it's unlikely that if you take a deal with the devil on the previous floor, that the next floor will not have one. It's almost guaranteed, I think. So, let's see. Before we do this, let's go into our shop. Our sister shop's right over here. We know that we're going to be able to make enough money. I might as well re-roll that. Skinny Auto Mushroom. There we go. So it's movement speed plus fire rate. That was basically a free Skinny Auto Mushroom. I mean, we'll take it. You may argue that I probably rerolled that a little bit too soon, and maybe you're right, maybe you're wrong, I don't know. Not here to judge. We don't know what this is. Health down, that's incredibly bad. Okay, so... Well... The battery is also pretty bad. Some people like the battery, I don't like the battery. If I had to choose between the battery and 9-volt, I'd go with 9-volt all day, every day. But luckily, that's what we have the D6 for. That's why Isaac is so great, because he's got the luxury of having the D6. Now, we're going to need a gamble for those keys. In hindsight, I probably should have waited to re-roll the shop until... until the blood bag. Until we knew that we didn't need money anymore. I can't overemphasize how bad the health down pill was. This pill right here, actually. It's really bad luck. Really, really bad. So that significantly decreases our chance to survive. Like a lot. By a lot. Alright, so we need keys here. Bombs are nice, keys are nicer. Keys are an Isaac's best friend sometimes. Take one key. Take a key for your thoughts. I would also take the dollar from the slot machine. That'd be nice. Wouldn't have to worry about money anymore. And we'd be able to buy the key that's in the shop. Instead of giving it all away to a really greedy Three Skull Monty. So, yeah. So we're not going to be able to gamble a key. That was 18 cents well spent. We did get an orbital out of it, which I guess is kind of like a... that sort of thing. Oh, look, a key. We were able to get a key without without spending a whole lot of money for it. We just go walk in, there's a key right there. So let's go see what's in our item room. The inner eye is a triple shot. I don't know if it augments brimstone like quad shot, though. I don't think it does. I'm going to reroll it. And that's movement speed, so yeah. I do not know, actually. That's just a matter of me being ignorant to the fact, because I honestly don't know if the inner eye, if triple shot is like quad shot in the sense that it augments brimstone's damage. I don't think it does, but I don't have any proof for that. And I know that Platinum God doesn't cover... Platinum God doesn't consider the inner eye as like one of the top tier damage augments, so it doesn't have... If you ever go to platinumgod.co.uk, which I highly recommend doing, by the way, because it's an amazing website, especially if you're trying to learn the Binding of Isaac for the first time, they have a damage calculator down at the bottom of the screen, of the main screen, that will calculate whether or not your damage... like if you have brimstone, for example, will your damage go up, down, or is it a side grade based on, you know, on what you combine brimstone with, or mom's knife, or technology, or whatever. And the inner eye is not considered one of those. It's not one of the variables. So there's no hard evidence to point to. Like, does the inner eye actually augment the damage of brimstone or not? I don't think it does. But I base that purely on a guess, an educated guess. I know for a fact that quad shot does, so logically, you would think that the inner eye would do the same thing, because just not to the degree of quad shot, because it's three shots instead of four, but the inner eye counts, I believe, as a special item, and I think that it's not augmented by Polyphemus, which would significantly change the way that it augments other damaging items. So, again, I don't know. This is just pure guessing right now that I'm doing. From what I've seen and from what I know based on what I've read on Platinum God. But I just don't know. That's just Invicta being good old ignorance Invicta sometimes. So, we're looking for... Yeah, we'll take Sacrificial Dagger. That's good. Sacrificial Dagger is super good. That finishes off our suite of orbitals, and we're going to be protected for the rest of the game. It doesn't win us the run by far. We're not tanky enough to face tank anything with it. Sacrificial Dagger does a ton of damage. I mean, a ton of damage, but you have to be in range, and it goes well with Guardian Angel, which I don't think I actually have unlocked yet. But what Guardian Angel is, it's a familiar that causes your familiars to spin at double their current rate. Which is really, really good, especially considering if you do have Sacrificial Dagger, it means that it revolves around you quicker, meaning that it will most likely be ready to damage again. Whereas right now, as you see, it's traveling quite slow. But we don't have that, and I don't think I have it unlocked yet on my account. Or not account, but my save file. Abel's quite bad, it's just a familiar. Nothing too sexy about that. So, Blue Chub. Speaking of Blue Chub. Blue Chub's not a bad matchup for us. We do have adequate movement speed, and we've got Brimstone, meaning that our shots are hitting three times instead of once. And then, of course, we're also Brim Snapping, which I've already talked about ad nauseum. Box is really good. Range down doesn't matter. Not going to take it, but it doesn't matter. Strength cards, quite nice. We'll take the red patch just because we don't have a trinket. Red patch is a one of those retribution items. If you get hit enough, it will start to augment your damage. Dead bird's really bad. Really, 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 really bad. We could get a reroll here, but I'm feeling a little bit lazy. So it's Pestilence. I don't know if I want the second level Cube of Meat, to be honest. Meat Boy seems to sometimes cause more damage, more problems than he solves. And I don't actually know if you get a second level cube of meat, if that does count as an orbital. Whoa there, Pestilence. Calm down. You're going to cause the game to lag, sir. deal with the devil. I don't know if I'm going to pick up the second level cube meat. Cubby's head. If Dead Cat was in here, I definitely would take it, but as it is, it's not. So we don't have a reroll. I kind of don't want to use the reroll for the deal with the devil room. I mean, I'll go back there and do just a quick peek to see if it's still there, but I'd really like to get another item out of this room, or out of this floor, rather. You see, our damage is not that great. It's not bad, but it's also not good. We haven't had any damage upgrades yet on Isaac. Key. Take a key. I'll happily take a key. Movement speed is in the sweet spot. This is right where I like it. Anything faster feels too fast. Anything slower is a liability. It's a good thing I don't drive like that. I don't. I'm actually quite a good driver. It's not really worth... Well, it might be worth two bombs to get there. I guess that would be only one bomb. Be essentially trading a bomb for a key. Okay. There we go. Yeah, we'll go grab that key. Alright, actually, I don't think... Yeah, we can. Okay. And just because we're here, there's a chance the Super Secret Room could be right here. There's also a chance it could be up here. There's a chance that I'm completely wrong, which... is a good chance to bet on. Especially when it comes to this game. So I'm going to go peek inside of the boss room to see if the deal with the devil room is still active. It's possible that it is still active. I mean, we've seen it before. So there's enough hearts for me to also get a couple pulls off of the blood donation machine. Whoops, that's not the boss room. This is the boss room. Oh, it's still active. Okay, this could be interesting. Dead cat for one, yeah. I don't even think there's a question about that. I mean, we're giving up one... It's like, you know, what are we really losing there? We're losing one heart. We already had a health down. You know? And actually, now that I think about that, that health down turns into a health up pill. I believe, anyway. Could be wrong about that. I think that if you have one heart, it turns into a health up. Health up, yep, there you go. So, that worked out beautifully. So, essentially, we gained 9 lives and didn't lose anything. And we got to stick it to the... man with that stupid old, that mean old health down pill. Showed him. We showed him who's boss. Boss the ones and zeros. I'm half tempted to blow up these rocks here. That's just a... kind of slowing us down. So, it's a long floor, just like any XL floor is, but that means that it holds special... That holds special meaning, because you need to make use of XL floors. If you can't maximize your efforts in an XL floor, then you're doing it wrong. Hoping for some keys here. There we... Well, that's hilarious game. I was happy. At first I was like, and then I was like, I don't know what this is. Tears up. Okay. It cancels out the other tears down pill that we had. Alright. Well, we're done here. That's about all I need to see. Get a key, get a spirit heart. Fine with that. And we're good. So, I would say that it's a pretty good floor for us. I mean, we got a guppy item. There's an outside chance of becoming Guppy. We got a Sacrificial Dagger, which is very nice. Our damage is not very good, but we do have Brimstone, and we got 9 lives. Like I said, we have a full suite of orbitals, which is also pretty good. I forget what was in here. Dead Bird. No, I'm not going to take Dead Bird. Dead Bird's quite bad. And it counts as a special item. I really don't like second level cube meat. I really don't. The shots from Meat Boy push bombs as well, which is also something you have to take into account when weighing whether or not you want a second level cube of meat versus do I want the annoyance of having one of my orbitals move a bomb, you know. So as you see there, the executable kind of goofed up a little bit. It's okay. As long as the game doesn't crash, I'm fine. All right, so we got the Depths 1. And again, with Brimstone, we should be relatively okay here. It's more of a, thank goodness we have triple orbitals. I say that as I get hit immediately. Because of these mobs I absolutely hate. Can't stand the leapers. Fat out mushrooms, super good. Damage up and it's a health up. It's a good start. Our damage is going to be adequate up through Mom's Heart. When we start getting into the womb is when the damage will really start to taper off. And I know I say that a lot, but it's true. It's the everything past Mom is basically a DPS check. So we get Pride. Pride should be no problem. Kind of worried about him doing something like that. Wow. So that's really good. It's really good that we got the Anarchist Cookbook right there, because that can turn into pretty much any item in the game, since it dropped off a mini-boss. Could use a key for a golden chest here. We'll see. Just gotta be careful trying to keep this guy from leaping. Get a key. Alright, so we will open one of those golden chests, not both of them. And tarot card is the Lovers. Well, I mean, I guess. Lovers is a tarot card that gives 2 hearts, by the way. Max's head, that's really good. So that's a damage up, that's a damage increase. That's 2 damage increases that we've gotten in 2 rooms on this floor. That's really, really good. So I will use a key to open up this other chest. That's to get us a bomb. We got our key back anyway, so we essentially just got a bomb out of that, and I'm okay with that. If there was an arcade on this floor, I would be keeping the Lovers card. But as it stands right now, the Strength card is going to be very useful against Mom. Let's go see what's in our shop. We know it can be a good shop. Steam sale. There's only one good shop after Depths 1. After Depths 2, there's no shops, so it's not really worth getting Steam sale. The only time the Steam sale is ever worth it is when it's early on in the game. We've been having some really weird even for my standards, like, we've been getting some really, really odd, like, telepills. Like we've been seeing telepills so often anymore, I'm almost expect it. There's still another pill that we haven't taken. I am going to check out the mob trap room. Just to see if there's anything in there, since we do have a reroll. We can't buy anything in the shop, so there's no point in me rerolling the Steam sale right now. Got another key. So now we'll open up that another golden chest. So Max's head helps out a lot. It's not quite the upgrade like Polyphemus is, but it's good. It is a damage upgrade. I believe that it does stack with Brimstone. I think it stacks with Brimstone. If it doesn't, I'm going to look like a really, really big idiot. But hey, that's okay, because I always look like a big idiot anyway, so there. Aha. Take your logic and make fun of something else of mine. So let's go see what's in this. It's going to cost us a bomb and a key, but we get one cent closer to possibly making the shop viable. Speed upgrade. Yeah, we will be rerolling that. Ghost Baby. Not a fan. The fact that Judgment's there is very interesting as well. It's almost guaranteed that the secret room would be here, not below the boss room. Okay. Maybe it's below the boss room. Tears up. It's good. Not boss. I meant mini boss room, by the way. Not the boss room. Look, whenever I say something that doesn't make sense, just know that I meant something else. It made sense in my unconscious, but it's the unconscious part of Sinvicta that you never hear, which is probably really good that you shouldn't. You shouldn't really ever want to hear my unconscious, because it would be quite boring. I rarely ever think. It's not where I wanted you, Monstro. I needed you to come a little bit more centered. There you go. You need to come back over here, buddy. I can't really hit you from there. There. Right there. That's fine. Perfect. There we go. Now we got him locked. We got him locked doing the doing the old winky dance. Which was the name of a famous play written by... Whoa! And we took a hit down there anyway because I'm terrible. And I ran into that one because I'm also very, very, very terrible. HP upgrade, I'll happily take. I'm just going to leave the winky dance metaphor to someone else. You can use that knowledge and apply it to whatever you want at this point. You can thank Invicta's brain for that. So we couldn't have gotten another deal. Holy moly, we could not have gotten another reroll on this floor because of the fact that there was not enough rooms. Therefore, it doesn't matter if I'm not using them now, because we're going to use them and then leave this floor anyway. English is really, really, really hard sometimes. Oh man, Super Meat Boy Super Fan. It's been a while since we've seen that one, and now we have a really, really weird looking Isaac. He's got the brimstone head, the Meat Boy body, the twerking child's heart off of his chest, and a floating cat head behind him. That's certainly... Oh, there's Judgment. I forgot. No, you know what? I'm not going to play it. That's a lot of backtracking, and this run's already approaching 30 minutes. It's okay. I do take some things into consideration, my fellow viewer. Your time and effort is always one of them. This room is quite bad. If we didn't have brimstone. Alright, so there's a library here. There's no arcade, which I'm actually a little bit sad about. So I was hoping to get a speed upgrade. At the very least, money. Utility. I mean, we can double our key to make two keys instead of one. Yeah, we'll take Stigmata. I don't think it's actually a damage upgrade, but I know for a fact, obviously, it's a health upgrade. That's very good. Now our Isaac is looking even more interesting. He's looking pretty heavy metal, I gotta say. I have a picture of... Or a picture. I have a screenshot of Judas. And it was a long time ago before I started doing the actual Isaac Victor series. And it's a picture of him that I had the Book of Belial proc'd, but I also had like I don't remember what items I had, but Judas looked really, really cool, and I took a screenshot of it and made it into a thumbnail, which is what I was going to use for the series, and then decided not to because I didn't want people thinking that I only play as Judas type thing. You know how the internet can be sometimes. But the Book of Belial makes anyone who uses it look really, really awesome. Very heavy metal. Of course, everyone knows I do have... Every now and then, I kind of get a little bit of metal. We can't get into our library unless if we can bomb our way in, which would be beautiful. I'm not arguing with that. We are striking out on the... Secret rooms. We haven't been doing too good getting those old secret rooms, unfortunately. Mob trap room is the anti-mob trap room, meaning that I have to be on low health for me to enter, and I'm not going to do that. So we still don't have enough money to really make our shop viable. We don't have any keys, which is also making me kind of cry on the inside. I don't know if the Two of Spades acts like the Two of Clubs. There's a super secret room. Thank you, Isaac from Statues. Appreciate that. So, one more last cheap shot there. Didn't work out. Curse Skull is really bad. Well, at least we didn't pay a bomb for it. That's all I can say. So we're wasting... Oh, so bad. We're wasting a lot of rerolls here just because of the fact that we don't have a key. And it's not really what I want to see happen. The only reason why I'm even clearing over here is because I'm hoping that we get a room that maybe drops a key. But it's not going to be the case. And it's possible we may be leaving not only the shop, but the library behind on this floor because of the fact we just don't have any keys. That would be quite unfortunate. I could bomb my way over to this fortune telling machine, and it may drop a key. Oh, thank goodness. Now I can use the two of spades to double the amount of keys that I have. I'm going to clear the last room in the, or the last room before the mom room to see if I can get one more key to double. So this will be at least the entrance to our library. Maybe an off chance we might get enough money to make the shop viable, but it's not looking good. No, we didn't get a key, so there you go. Two keys, Book of Revelations, it's Spirit Heart, we'll take it. Book of Belial, Book of Sin. Oh ho, we get a key. Which doesn't really matter because we don't have enough money to make the shop viable, but we need to try anyway because this is the last shop that we're going to get, and it's worth having one key to do that. And this last key we could possibly spend on a golden chest. I don't really want to, but beggars can't be choosers, and we're certainly begging for a lot. And it's greed. So, yeah. Oh well. Can't say we didn't try. Steam sale, sure. No longer matters. So, in the end, I mean, this floor wasn't all that bad. We were able to finally access everything that we wanted to. It just took us forever and a day to do so. Chances of beating Mom are pretty good. I don't see us having too many difficulties with it. What's nice about the mom fight is that, at least the way that I handle the mom fight, is that I usually stay very close range, so our sacrificial dagger can get in and really get some solid licks on Mom, even when she's close to the door. I am going to open this golden chest because, just to see. Yeah, well. Rest in peace is key. Alright, so it's regular Mom. I don't know about that one. We took damage from the eye that was behind us, that the door was already closed. Alright. You'll get that one, Bunny, Isaac. We'll get you back. Don't worry. That was really bad damage. I was expecting the foot to come down a bit. You should never, ever go near the doors, by the way, because of that hand. It does tons of damage. So as you see, our damage is not that bad. Get an HP upgrade. Very nice. Polaroid is significantly better than the red patch, and we're good. So we've got kind of a budget run in a way, but I'm not going to complain about it because we've had our fair share of budget runs for the past few videos here. So there's our half heart interval. We'll take it. We're certainly not in a one run scenario though. That should not have happened. I don't know how that thing did not get killed by Brimstone. And given how sloppy I've been playing for the past couple of days now, I mean, it's nothing's really set in stone here. I would love to get a movement speed upgrade because unfortunately our speed downgrade from Super Meat Boy is quite bad. And we don't have flying. We haven't had flying in a very long time, actually. That was really terrible damage. Really, really, really awful damage. Range down, doesn't matter. I mean, I would love to play that blood bank. I would. I really would. I don't know how the hollow is still up. Isaac's Fork is actually would be viable if we had Mom's purse. Isaac's Fork is a trinket that sometimes heals you for half a heart after you're clearing a room. It's not as good as Charm of the Vampire, but almost took that. Let's go do our boss, see who it is. And it's Loki 2. Ooh. Well, thank goodness we have two orbitals, that's all I can say. But without flying, Loki, any version of Loki is a little bit harrowing. A little bit scary. Need to not get that close, by the way. There we go. Whew. Oh, man. And we got meat. Alright, so that makes me feel a lot better. Deal with the devil secured. The mark and the pact. It's a lot of damage. Is it worth two hearts for? Four hearts, really. Oh. You can't say Sinvicta doesn't try to go big or go home. I could go for the blood bank, but honestly, I don't want to throw another run because of a blood bank. And the mark and the pact really, really boost our damage. It's still not Polyphemus quad shot brimstone damage, but it's good enough now. That's really what this game is about, just having good enough. Now, surprisingly, we actually are lacking in some keys. Keys are something that we do need for the chest, so I'm hoping that we get some good red heart drops here. That we can play the blood bag. Play for the blood bag, which would also be nice because we have movement speed. There we go, so that's at least three plays. And I will, since we have the Polaroid, I'm willing to go pretty hard on this blood bank. So, next one should be Polaroid Invincibility. There we go. Yes. Come on, Blood Bank, don't be so cruel, man. I don't really want to nuke all of our Spirit Hearts. By the way, that's the reason why we keep losing a Spirit Heart and gaining a half heart, is because of the fact that this blood bank is doing one full heart of damage, not half heart. I wouldn't mind getting Fly Love here, because that gives us a pedestal to re-roll. Looking for keys and hearts. Don't really need bombs. Pills would be okay if it's a health up. There's keys, very nice. Heart, it's gonna give us another play on the blood bank. Blood bank Arena. That equates to another heart, so we'll take that. Can't tell if that's a double half heart or just one. It looks like it may just be one. It came out at a weird angle, so I'm not entirely sure whether or not that's one half heart or if that's one that's on top of another half heart. Well, it doesn't matter anymore now. Okay, it was only one. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Beautiful. Very beautiful. Well, we got keys and we got the blood bag, so we're good now. We're done. One key for good measure. I'll bomb him, see if we get a spirit heart. That was probably going to be the one that we were going to get Fly Love on, but what can you do? Alright, so we got movement speed. We got net HP upgrade. Ooh, judgment. This could be interesting. We're going in the wrong direction for our boss room, though. Alright, judgment. I haven't played you in a little while, man. Good to see you again. Gives us another HP upgrade, which I'm not going to be upset about at all. So we've actually essentially already paid for one of our Deal with the Devil items, and we're coming away with it faster and stronger than we were. So, yep, I totally feel okay with the Deal with the Devil that I did. And again, our damage is nothing really to write home about, but it's also nothing to sneeze at. Which I never understood that saying, because, I mean, how can you sneeze at something? Unless it's like you're purposely trying to sneeze on, like, a person or an object, which is borderline, you know, borderline inconsiderate, just downright rude. And we should be flying through the rest of this run. It's not a one run. Certainly not a one run here. Needlessly lost a spirit heart there. That's all right. As long as I don't do it too often. Don't make a habit of it, you know. It's kind of like, yeah, you can use an entire bag of bacon on that baked potato if you want, but just don't do it every single day. That way you don't die by the time you're 30. There we go. So, Mom's Heart should be a breeze. Again, our damage isn't really... It's nothing that we can write home about. It's not going to knock the ballpark out of the stadium, if you catch my meaning, but it's okay. It's okay. I mean, we've got a couple of decent damage upgrades. At this point, judging from my damage, I'm willing to almost say that Max's head does not stack with Brimstone. Because I don't honestly see any damage difference between when we had Max's head and when we didn't. So we'll get close, let the Sacrificial Dagger get in there and get a couple good licks. Took a hit there. We probably should have taken a hit. So she's in permabomb mode, and I'm going to rotate away from the demon flies. Don't have flying. Haven't had flying in quite a long time. There's a library on this floor, but honestly, I don't think we need to make a really. I don't think we need to make a play for it. I'll go ahead and touch it just to and re-roll it just to get some items out of the way for the chest. But I'm not going to do what I did on the last run. The last time we were in this predicament where I basically just re-rolled, force re-rolled, you know, my way to a double item room type thing. I don't think we need to. I mean, it's nice. It would be nice to do, and if I wasn't so worried about time, then I certainly would do it, but... Meh. I think we'll be okay. Triple orbital. We don't have Polaroid invincibility. Our damage is adequate. You know, we have a decent amount of health. It's not the best situation, but, I mean, you're not always going to be able to min-max your way out of the Binding of Isaac. Unless you're Biznap or somebody. I've actually tried watching a couple of Biznap's videos, and he's extremely well versed in the game. He thinks about the game a lot differently than I do. But I find that the hyper, that's a health down, I know that. The hyper min maxing stuff is just not my, like, it's not really my cup of tea. I can totally respect someone for who does it. Yeah, that's amazing that you have that amount of patience and knowledge to learn about one game. You know, that's great. It just doesn't work for me. Like, I prefer just kind of like the laid-back, entertaining style. Like, Northern Lions, you know, Binding of Isaac series is quite addicting, to be quite honest. So, we've got Isaac here, and we are not on a half-heart interval, so we are going to have to be slightly careful. And as you do see, our damage is not that good. Not that bad, but we do not have the luxury of being able to face tank with the Sacrificial Dagger. So that's why I'm hoping, I was secretly hoping in the library, which I will go back and re-roll, by the way, before we get to the chest. I was secretly hoping that we'd find the Book of Shadows in there so I could face tank it. And I don't think we've seen the Book of Shadows yet on this run. But I've recorded multiple runs today. Well, multiple videos today, I should say. So the Isaac runs kind of merge together into one long Isaac run. Like, do we have Luckfoot? Do we have? I know we're not Guppy, but did we get, you know, this item or that item? And right here is another. This is another good example of why I highly value movement speed. Movement speed is a very, very big one. I jokingly said that movement speed to me is like FOV sliders to TB. It's not something that people really think about, but some people value things differently than others. I mean, that's kind of like a herpa-derpa, yeah, we know type thing. Taking a little bit more damage than I'm comfortable with. We're certainly not immortal, and the angel fetuses are not helping. So there's our half-heart interval. We will have that to go to the next floor. Like I said, I am going to go back and re-roll the library real quick. I think that if we get the Book of Shadows, that might be good enough for us to win over Blue Baby. It'd be better if we had Nun's Habit, of course. I mean, Nun's Habit, Book of Shadows is one of my favorite combos in the game. So, there's the Book of Shadows. Do I take the chance of taking it down to Blue Baby and leave the D6 behind? I'd say yeah, because yes, re-rolling everything on the chest is nice, but it may not help you beat Blue Baby, if that makes sense. And I'm going to take a risk. There's going to be a lot of people who say that this was a bad move, and it could be a bad move. It all depends. Infestation's not that bad. Large slows us down. Scapular. Get the Hangman's flying, so whatever. To be honest, I'm okay with all these. That could have been the chest room could have been a lot worse. This might be. I don't think we need to use Book of Shadows here. We need to not get hit by anything. That's what we need to not happen. 30 Senior is not exactly my idea of a good boss to fight. Trying to get in close just to get the Sacrificial Dagger some licks in there. There we go. I don't care about a bomb. I'm willing to bet that the boss room is probably over to the right here. Daddy Long Legs again, an annoying boss, but certainly not the worst thing to face in the chest. It's not like a Death Conquest type of deal. There we go. Tarot card. Ooh, the Sun card. That might be the game clincher there. That's the that might be the clutch. That might be the seals the deal. This would be a Book of Shadows room if we weren't already right outside the boss room. I wouldn't even mess with this room. But yeah, the Sun card. Sun card's definitely going to be the that's going to be the game clincher there. So feeling good. We should have this. Even though we're not on a half heart interval, I'm going to wait till we're down to like literally one health, and then I'm going to pop Book of Shadows and then pop the Sun card. I've already taken a lot of damage, which is actually not very good. That was not shot damage. It was just flies, which is kind of annoying. Thank goodness we have the Sun card. If we didn't have the Sun card, I would be feeling much, much, much worse about our situation. So Blue Baby's actually rocking our faces right now. Gonna use Book of Shadows and get in close. Do as much damage as possible. Then we use the Sun card, get the full heal, and now it's gonna have to be up to our defense and movement speed. I could get in there and face tank it. If I had a half heart interval, I would. I'm trying to play it safe here. You're almost guaranteed to take at least one hit if you cross Isaac like that. Or cross a Blue Baby, rather. I guess it is Isaac, but let's not get into that. Run up to him. There we go. No reason to be afraid at this point. There we go. So we end up getting a win, albeit a little bit longer one than usual. But hey, I'll take a win. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. See you next time for a random run here in the Binding of Isaac Victa. I'll see you next time.